It had 10 major battles, and ultimately resulted with the victory for the rebels, the end of the Targaryen dynasty and the start of the Baratheon dynasty. In the prelude to the rebellion we have Tourney at Harrenhal. After winning the final tilt, Prince Rhaegar Targaryen was to crown the new Queen of Love and Beauty. Instead of crowning his wife, the Dornish princess Aelia Martell, Rhaegar rode past her and crowned Lyanna Stark of Winterfell instead, who was betrothed to Robert Baratheon. Eddard Stark would later recall this moment as the moment when all smiles died. At the coming of the new year, the Starks received a message of Lyanna Stark's abduction by Prince Rhaegar Targaryen near Harrenhal. Her brother Brandon Stark was on his way to Riverrun to wed Catelyn Tully when the news reached him. Brandon rode at once to King's Landing with his companions. Brandon rode for the Red Keep, and outside its gates, unaware that Rhaegar was not present, shouted for him to come out and die. King Aerys II had them all arrested for plotting the murder of the Crown Prince, and summoned the fathers of all those who stood accused at court. Lord Rickard Stark, who had been on his way south with the wedding party for Brandon's wedding, went to King's Landing with 200 men. None of them returned north. In King's Landing, all of those who stood accused were executed, with the sole exception of Ethan Glower. King Aerys did allow for trials of a sort. Lord Rickard Stark demanded a trial by battle, and the king granted his request. Rickard dressed for battle, but Aerys declared Fire to be the champion of House Targaryen. He had Rickard suspended from the rafters in the throne room, where his pyromancers kindled a blaze beneath the Lord of Winterfell. Brandon Stark was brought in as well, and placed in a Tyroshi strangling device, while a longsword was placed just outside his reach. Brandon was allowed to try and free his father, but more he struggled to reach the sword, the tighter the cord around his neck became. Brandon strangled himself in an attempt to reach the sword and save his father, while Lord Rickard cooked in his armor. Next, Aerys demanded that Lord Jon Arryn sends him the heads of Lord Robert Baratheon of Storm's End, Lyanna betrothed, and Eddard Stark, now the Lord of Winterfell, after the deaths of his father and older brother. Robert and Eddard were Jon's wards at the Eyrie, however, and Jon instead raised his banners in revolt. This act is seen as the start of the war, which would last close to a year. Not all the lords in the Vale had sided with Jon Arryn, and not all the lords in Stormlands sided with Robert Baratheon. Robert himself firstly defeated those who sided with King Aerys in the Vale, and then fought and won 3 battles in one day in the Stormlands, against those who sided with King Aerys there. The next major battle was the Battle of Ashford, where Robert Baratheon was defeated by Randall Tarly, which was the only defeat for Robert in the entire war. Robert managed to escape capture with the bulk of his forces. Following the battle, Mace Tyrell marched on Storm's End and laid siege to the castle. Eddard Stark had managed to reach Winterfell, where he called his banners. He marched south with his forces and joined up with Lord Jon Arryn. Together they negotiated with Lord Hoster Tully, the Lord of Riverrun, for support. Meanwhile, Hand of the King to the Mad King John Connington led a mighty army into the field. The forces he commanded gave chase, and Robert's march became a grueling one. Robert, wounded through unknown means and all alone, eventually took refuge at Stony Sept, which would become the site of our next battle, the Battle of the Bells. John Connington's forces took the town by force and began to search every house. The residents of the town were actively helping Robert, however, and despite the search, then offered pardons, rewards, and threats. They could not find Robert. The battle began when Lord Stark and Tully arrived with a rebel army. The soldiers fought in the streets and alleys and on rooftops, and septons rang the bells to warn the residents to lock their doors. The battle was fierce, and John Connington managed to wound Hoster Tully and kill Jon Arryn's cousin Sir Dennis Arryn. Eventually, Robert Baratheon came out of the Peach, a brothel in which he had been hiding, and fought with Connington, almost killing him. With both Albert Arryn and Dennis Arryn now dead, Jon Arryn was in need of an heir. Hoster Tully swiftly betrothed his daughter Lysa to Jon. In a double ceremony at Riverrun, Eddard Stark and Jon Arryn married Hoster's daughters, Catelyn and Lysa, respectively. The Crown Prince finally returned from the south and convinced Aerys to ask Tywin Lannister for help, just as rebels had or would do at one point. Additionally, Aerys commanded his alchemists to place caches of wildfire on multiple locations in King's Landing, after at first refusing to send aid to Aerys, both due to his caution, as well as due to his anger over Aelia's treatment. Prince Doran Martell agreed to send 10,000 Dornishmen to strengthen the army Prince Rhaegar Targaryen was gathering. The Battle of the Trident was the next and decisive battle in the war, fought in 283 AC between the Loyalists and Rebels. The battle took place at a place known as the Ruby Ford, since the battle located on the northern bank of the Trident, where Rhaegar tried to cross the river. The Loyalists had 40,000 men, while the army of the Rebels numbered less men, who were more battle-hardened. Rhaegar and Lord Robert Baratheon met in single combat, with the battle raging on all around them. Rhaegar managed to wound Robert before Robert killed Rhaegar with a blow to the chest from his warhammer. Eventually, the Targaryen host broke and ran. Around the time the Battle of the Trident was fought, Robert proclaimed his intention to claim the Iron Throne. Out of all three leaders of the rebellion, Robert had the better claim, due to the fact that his grandmother had been Princess Rhaella Targaryen, the youngest daughter of King Aegon V Targaryen. To justify Robert's claim, the Maesters would later use his blood ties to House Targaryen, although it was actually the conquest which won him the throne. Already prior to the Battle of the Trident, King Aerys had been preparing his wildfire plot. Aerys sent his wife Queen Rhaella pregnant with Daenerys, along with his new heir Prince Viserys to Dragonstone for safety. While the Trident is seen by many as the decisive battle of the war, the capital remained untaken, until the sack of King's Landing when Tywin Lannister showed up at capital to finish the rebellion, when Aerys hoped Tywin would help him. Upon realization that all was lost, Aerys ordered Rosard to ignite the wildfire caches throughout the city, wishing to leave Robert nothing but ashes and bones. He ordered Ser Jaime Lannister, Lord Tywin's eldest son, to kill Tywin and bring his head to Aerys. Instead, Jaime killed Rosard, and upon realization that Aerys would simply give the order to burn the city down to another pyromancer, returned to the Red Keep, and killed Aerys himself in the throne room, while Tywin's men killed Rhaegar's wife and children. Robert was pleased by these deaths, but Eddard was furious. This resulted in an argument between Eddard and Robert, and Eddard rode out alone in anger to fight the final battles of the war in the south. After lifting the siege at Storm's End, Lord Eddard Stark rode further south to the Tower of Joy, and after battling the legendary Kingsguard, he found his sister Lyanna dying after giving birth to Rhaegar's child. The final battle of the war was assault on Dragonstone, where the last Targaryens were. Rhaella died giving birth to Princess Daenerys Targaryen during a great storm that destroyed the Targaryen fleet at anchor at the island. With most of the Targaryen fleet destroyed, and with the Baratheon fleet ready to take Dragonstone, the household of the last Targaryen stronghold was willing to sell the children to the new king, Robert I Baratheon. Shortly before Stannis sailed to Dragonstone, however, Willem Dary and four loyal men smuggled Viserys Daenerys and her vet nurse from the nursery, and sailed for the Bravosian coast, and the children subsequently lived in exile in the Free Cities. Following the conclusion of the rebellion, Robert I Baratheon was successfully installed as the new Lord of the Seven Kingdoms. Robert named his foster father Jon Arryn as his Hand of the King. Robert had no wish to marry following the death of his betrothed Lyanna Stark, but Jon convinced him to marry Lord Tywin's daughter Cersei, as the marriage would ensure Tywin's support, should Viserys Targaryen ever attempt to win his throne back. That's the story of the Robert's Rebellion. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up, and I hope to see you in the next one. Peace!